capital letters, welcome, lowercase, to capital letters, insurance, lowercase, with Ken and Will.
Yes.
Click, chunk. Kelso looks out into the resonating silence.
Just super just looks out like, what's going on?
He looks at the sandwich in his passenger seat that he kind of just balled up and left there because he was only going to be here for like 10 minutes.
He has a nice car, though.
Hey, Sandwich Phelps.
Oh, sorry, Sandwich Phelps. I sat on you for a little bit. I almost did the exact
fucking car.
Fucking
that's how you know we're playing.
I did we're the same thing as last time. I'm so sad.
Right. I mean, it's a left turn out of a parking space as the first turn on the car in the game. It's not going to be a lucky one.
Oh, God.
Almost wombo combo.
Almost wombo comboed. I was going to stop anyway to be like, what the fuck are you doing in the middle of a crosswalk? But my question was answered. Just wants to get hit by a car.
So we are currently Kelso, whose benefits include not a cop.
Not a
and
cop.
Drawbacks include not a cop.
Not a cop. Listens to good radio, though.
Knows the good dudes.
Yep.
He answers his call of duty.
Yep. Fulmer, soldier boy.
Hates Phelps.
Hates Phelps so much.
Phelps hates him.
So much.
And it's funny because, like, neither of them is the good guy or the bad guy, because both of them are the person who just kind of unreasonably hate each other.
Yeah.
Like, they're both the bad guy, but it's almost like they're willingly just being like, I need a guy to hate.
Yeah. Like, it's one of those things of, like, two similar individuals hating each other's guts just because of how similar they are. Hello, this is Elysian Fields now. Oh god. This is so messy.
They're soaking.
They're soaking. Hello. They got a quality calendar. Mm-hmm. Okay, we got some cement delivery.
That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners.
I see. What about this one? City of Los Angeles, pursuant to section 191, part 1, subsection A of the California Building Code, hereby order that any building work at Normandy Avenue subdivision associated with the incident of January 28th, 1947?
The injury.
Be immediately demolished and all building material removed from the site. I see. I was more so parsing the date. Because the U.S. has weird date formats.
The U.S. does, the Brits do, and then also, like, French Canadians insist on it too.
Why?
And it's like, why do you all just do two number, two number, two number if none of you are going to agree on a how?
Yeah.
Like,
if someone walks up to you and says, what's today's date? And you're feeling lazy, you're not going to list the month. Mm-hmm. You're going to list the day. That is the first thing and the only thing that people will care about.
Look at that highway plan. It's going right through Wilshire.
Wow. Interesting. It's all part of the master plan.
It's part of the plan.
Someone's here. Their hats are here.
Hey,
Oh.
You just can't be walking around down here. I'm Jack Kelso from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off.
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter. And
you deaf? Do I have to beat on you?
Looks like you do.
Okay.
Sounds like a beat off.
Came to see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to show me the way.
Kelso is way better at this than Phillips.
Don't know what you're looking for, smart guy. There's nothing there.
Like, part of that was luck. Part of that was just hitting me over and over. But it's also just like, Kelso hits fast. Yeah. So it's like,
just keep swinging. Oh, it's great.
Like a bobblehead, like doogity doogity doogity.
Yeah.
Thank you for listening to KTI Radio.
Yeah, it's not far at all.
California and the West Coast with music.
You heard nothing.
I didn't hit that lumber.
Place falls down.
You heard nothing. See, it's perfectly parked.
What gives here?
I've been doing a pre-play of GTA 5, which is going to take a decent, or GTA 4, which is going to take a decent amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, it does the same thing where it's, like, it'll just, like, magic break you, and then it's, like, you start and you're, like, pleasantly parked at the beginning of a mission. Even if you just, like, slid into it at, like, 100 yeah. kilometers an hour sideways, like... Okay, so our wood is not for this.
Yeah, not for construction use. Our brick appears to be a brick of some variety. Probably not great brick, all things considered.
Mm-hmm. Makes me think of the fire before.
Yeah, but that was low quality cement, which again is another thing that
yeah,
we listed.
He saw it and he was like, "Ah, oh, my dad, cement."
Daddy didn't raise no fool. Hi. You want to talk to me at all? No? Okay.
This guy must have escaped a loony bin.
Let's try to piece this together.
Are we going to rebuild the house? Oh!
Stone Films. Who gets their lumber from a film studio?
Oh, he's going to run me down. Oh shit, that's actually fast. He's going for it.
Man, that speed would be such an uncomfortable ride. Holy shit.
Oh shit.
Oh no.
Got donked.
I did get donked. I got donked in the badonkadonk.
This one is finicky.
Yeah.
This one gave me some grief, as you may say.
Yeah. Because he raises the thing, so it's like, oh, well, shit. I guess I'm just going to run for a little bit.
Son of a bitch.
Let's see if I can just firefly.
Just run.
No.
Oof.
Oh, culverted. That's a bad time right there. All right. This is going to take me a little bit.
Our loader at work is like... Oof.
Yeah, I really gotta wait till we're in that high point.
Our loader is menacing because, like, the way a loader moves is like it's a center pivot that's kind of right underneath your feet. Mm-hmm. So if you turn like one direction, like the rear and the front will turn.
Oh, fun.
And so, like, it's actually a really, once you get used to it, it's an insanely agile machine.
Oh, yeah. Like, that's what it's designed for. It's super good for that.
Oh, yeah. But it's also, like, if you really want to angle your turn right and have your bucket in the right position, sometimes you'll, like, swing out so that, like...
Damn it!
Yeah, I think it's got to be the one shot.
Like, okay, how am I supposed to do the one shot, though? Because I don't really get a whole lot of time.
I think you just got to drill it. It doesn't have to hit him.
Doesn't have to hit him? Oh, okay.
Son of a bitch.
Just like that is perfect. Just shoot, shoot, go. Like on top here.
Oh, shit.
Go.
Oh, I'm going. Go! Fucking...
No! Ah! Well, apparently you were doing very well to have that much time.
No! Fucking, it got stuck. I couldn't move.
Bug leg stuck.
Bug leg stuck. Game trash. Trash like the construction material used to build these houses.
Son of a bitch.
Go. Yeah, top of that next one. Go.
Okay. I went the wrong way. I went the wrong way.
Ooh, right after this pipe thing.
Yep.
Go. Good shit.
Good shit.
You're doing it, you're doing it, you're doing it, you're doing it, you're doing it. Now.
This just seemed like a good spot. Yeah.
Now you are the one who has been culverted. You can't arrest him.
I was gonna say, like... Oh, right. I'm not a cop. I forgot.
You could shoot him.
I could shoot him. But that would be self-defense. That would be justifiable self-defense. But, you know...
To be fair, this guy now has to... be accountable for what he's done.
He just destroyed so much shit. The piping system for this house? Fucking ruined. This entire block. Ruined.
Heavens to Betsy!
Oh, I wish I could afford that.
Goddamn Harry thinks he could get fresh whenever he pleases.
Here we go.
He's going to Subway day and night.
Jack Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator.
I need so an address from
the Keystone Film Company.
In university. Not anymore now, but, you know.
658 North Wilton Place.
You remember when that whole Dr. Disrespecting went down when the allegations came out?
Yeah.
I saw a picture that was, like, captioned, and it's... an ad from Subway that's like for a special promotion with Dr. Disrespect, and it's like, man, I can't believe they did this twice.
Man, if I had a nickel for every single time I hired a sex offender, I'd have two nickels, but it's weird it happened twice. Hey, I had the green light. Oh, yeah. I'm not a cop. I don't have to worry about that. I did look at this. We have statistics, Will. I noticed this before stream. So we are 18 out of 21 cases complete. That's huge.
Oh, yeah.
But the number that I liked the most was the vehicles section. 5 hours spent driving.
Wow.
I mean, most of this game is investigating a location and then driving to another location, and I haven't been having the other people drive at all. Except for the last little while where, you know, a mission just took us way out in the middle of nowhere.
Do they have your total expenses?
No, it doesn't look like they have the total expenses.
Because it might be three figures. It might not. Mm-hmm, or sorry, mm-hmm. six figures.
It might be. It might be.
No, not six figures. Sorry. Because it's usually in the thousands.
It's definitely five figures.
Definitely five, maybe six.
But also, I like these gun statistics because I hit 50% of my shots, but they're headshots. And also, clearly I have a favorite. 606 shots fired with pistols, 10 shotgun shots, 39 rifle shots, 0 automatics.
Okay, you have to get the fucking Tommy out then. You have to experience the joy of it.
At this point, you know what? Maybe I will, because, like, Phelps, cowboy. Definite cowboy. I've been playing him cowboy the entire time.
Yeah.
But, yo, Kelso, he gets shit done. Maybe the Tommy is the best solution for him.
Listen, he left to join a rifle corps.
Yeah. He's gonna be using a rifle.
Pistols are for officers.
Yeah. So they can hold a clipboard in one hand and shoot people with the other. Mm-hmm. Ooh.
There's a big sigh. It goes, Reeves, bang. Scarborough, bang. Caesar, bang. Ah, shit, no, this is the roll call. Wrong sheet.
The next person in line is just like, thank fuck. Right. Holy shit.
Oh, watch it!
I work for California Fire and Life. I'm looking into an industrial accident.
Here?
No, not here. At a housing development over on Normandy Avenue.
So?
I found some lumber over there, had the Keystone name printed on it.
We've been closed since 41. Never quite made the transition to talkies. The suburban redevelopment fund are pulling the place
down. You never know where you're going to go.
Yeah.
Know anything about the
suburban redevelopment fund? Genuinely, this is one of the things where it's like, this could be a cool way to live my life.
Mind if I take a look around?
Take some time. We'll take more credentials, more experience. I'm kind of hungry.
Life insurance investigation or guarding a shutdown movie studio? Down the
street. I was going to say industrial accident investigation. Key to the gate?
Fair enough.
No. The only guys who go
I'm tired of people doing stupid fucking dangerous shit. They're working on a housing development. And the only thing I'm more sick of than that is people's bosses forcing them to do it because they don't want to spend money.
Yeah, fair enough.
I want to yell at people's managers, man.
Oh, I want to yell at every manager in the world.
But what if it was your job?
If it was my job, I would do a good job of it. I know I say that now, but, like, genuinely, that's the track I choose, is the managerial side of things. It's where I have the most fun when I actually get to work. I say that as a person who just programs full-time. I don't want to program. I don't want to program anymore. I'm done with it.
Yeah, there's a point where it's like, okay, all of these are kind of just utilities.
Yeah.
None of these are fun.
Yeah.
I imagine that's why you've gone full into the VTuber too. It's like, this is actually something enjoyable that I will utilize.
Yeah, like it's one of those things where I'm like, look, I am an anxious, like I'm an anxiety riddled person. I have always been anxious. I don't like showing my face on camera. But the VTuber side of things, I know, like my hands tend to be very animated when I talk. So I was like, I still want that. And so that's where the VTuber side came in. I immediately looked into how I can do hand tracking. And I was like, I need that. Once I have that, I am like set and I can do this.
Look, glasses, brown hair, Mass Effect hoodie. We're good. It's all about the gesturing, okay?
Yep, it's all about them gesturing.
Thank you.
great day for the future of I found it. Civic leaders and
businessmen right joined back.
Forces to launch the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges to speed up housing development for returning GI.
Gentlemen, this is Dr. Harlan Fontaine.
He's our latest. Hey, we know him.
The Suburban Redevelopment Fund. Doctor, this is Curtis Benson. He's vice president of the California Fire and Life.
Pleased to meet you, Doctor.
Ray Gordon,
editor of the Times.
Doctor. Leland Monroe, the doctor, and your fucking boss.
Yeah.
The police chief.
Yep.
God damn it.
Yeah, like literally the entire town is in on this.
Every time this scene happens, I'm always so nervous because I just expect to be shot in the head.
Right.
Like, anytime it's like, oh, you're investigating something sinister, anyone could turn against you, you don't know who to trust. Look in one direction away from a door for a while.
Yeah.
Hear, hear. That is something that every sucker getting off a train at Union Station wants a part of. Gentlemen, we're here to sell the American dream, and Hollywood is our greatest advertiser.
So, how is your new development selling, Leland?
They got a lot of camera angles for this.
And that's part of the problem, Leland. Washington is receiving steady complaints. There's a clamor for public housing.
God damn it, Ray. Public housing is tantamount to communism. Now that's why we fought this
public housing. Public.
You, it's via the back door.
You can't have it both ways, Leland.
You know what would be great? Are being built to service affordable living. That'd be great.
They're all being built with government money.
People are always like, oh, more of the concrete Soviet blocks. It's like, what maybe difference? A little square that the actually GI has, like, reliable plumbing.
Yeah.
Our pockets, Leland. We're all investors.
Of course, Curtis.
Maybe it's someone's job that isn't me to clean up the raccoon shit.
Yeah.
It still has to be ratified. It takes a long time to raise.
Also, never make a covered staircase.
I need to find a game well or a telephone.
Yeah.
Animals just think it's a hide. That's all that happens.
Yeah, that's fair.
And then there's no wind and rain to naturally clean it the way you would with like a deck or an exposed staircase.
Yeah.
It's not warm and like. Like, it's not warm and it's not secure from outside things because it's not an indoor staircase.
Yeah, basically it has no benefit being covered.
It's just a barn. You have to walk through a barn on the way to your apartment.
Yeah.
Pleased to meet you, Doctor.
Ray Gordon, editor of the Times.
The only benefit it has over uncovered is the fact that the stairs will presumably last longer. And that's it.
You saw the canister, you saw the movie. I think there's a lumber pile, and there's an order for them.
A lumber pile?
I normally wouldn't, like, I would give you a minute, but it's also like there is so much wood everywhere that
there
it
is
just doesn't make
this
it
is a good. Big plate. So, that's fair. So that's the screening room. That's that. Okay. Oh, fireproof warehouse. Excellent. Oh, lumber pile. Nope. Apparently not that lumber pile. A box. Nope. Yo, this is some good equipment you could steal.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this looks more like a lumber pile to me.
Oh, yeah. This has got to be the place. Is something's this, got a ding.
What does this say? Nope. Keystone Film Lumber. Alright. Oh, I guess I could have hopped the fence there. Did not notice that. There we go.
So this is where their lumber comes from?
I mean, seems like a pretty good deal on lumber, but it's not really living lumber, so... Yeah.
Yeah, leaving stuff in the yard outside, maybe it's good in the desert, but it's awful up here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, your wood is ruined in a year.
It's one way to keep your costs down. Too bad it won't support a roof.
Alright, so was that everything?
Yep. But there's also a... There's a phone inside of that security booth. Which, like, it is wild to me that they would have a manned security booth at an abandoned building.
Yeah.
Like, operator, I'd be you glad see toll booths everywhere, and there is never anyone in.
Yeah.
You through now.
It is one of those things, absolutely Kelso, impressive, that it would be...
Can you put me through to Curtis Benson, please?
Like, you would need to hire someone to look over your abandoned property.
Jack, how can I help?
Do you know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund, Mr. Benson?
I've heard of them, Jack. Building new homes for GIs.
With green lumber that was used on movie sets.
Jack, are you working the Buckwalter case?
Mr. Benson,
are you part of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
Jack, I want you to listen very clearly. Call Miss Lichtman. Call her as soon as you hang up. Arrange to see her tonight and get her to agree to the settlement. Do it tonight. Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
End of story, Jack. I don't want to hear another word about Elsa Lichtman or Lou Buckwalter.
Can you put me through to Michigan 221?
Putting the call through.
Thank you, operator.
Hello. Ms. Lichtman, it's Jack Kelso.
Yes, Mr. Kelso.
I've been looking into your case.
Yes, and what have you found?
It doesn't look good. I need to see you.
Meet me at the Blue Room. I work there tonight. I take a break around 9. I'll be waiting at the stage door. We can talk then. Auf Wiedersehen, Mr. Kelso.
Thanks, ma'am.
What do you think of this whole situation, Sandwich Phelps?
Tuna sound. Mail.
Oh, it's regular Phelps.
Baby, you know oh! Jack looks up from his sandwich.
Like, huh? Starts mentioning conversations that Phelps has no idea what he's talking about.
Remember that concrete pillar outside of the baseball stadium? Phelps is like, what are you talking about? He's like, well, you were like garlic. Never mind.
You were a nice pastrami on rye.
Listen, Phelps, my therapist says it's okay.
My therapist told me to do it this way.
What were you doing with him?
Phelps goes through his garbage. There's just a bunch of sandwiches to punch to meet him in an alleyway.
Why do you snarl at me? Your friend came to ask me to accept the insurance.
He's not my friend, Elsa.
I think he's a brave man, and you have placed him in great danger. You've involved him in something, and he has no idea of the risks. Can you live with that, Cole?
Elsa, I need his help, and he hates my guts.
Forget the past, Cole. He deserves the chance to say no. If he helps you, let it be on his terms.
I'll go see him in the morning.
Sandwich Phelps, can you believe this betrayal? Regular Phelps is making a move.
There's something funny about the clam chowder.
What? What's funny about the clam chowder? What's wrong with it? No!
That's Sandwich Phelps.
Oh, I see.
He wants you to investigate a suspect.
The clam chowder is wanted for 2 cases of delicious.
One count of prosciutto, 2 of Genoa salami, 3 of provolone.
Oh, damn, that's a good sandwich.
My sandwich decision is that I always choose spinach over lettuce. If I will eat a green, I will eat the beef of greens.
You know what? Same here. I always choose spinach over lettuce. I always find that the spinach is fresher than the lettuce. Or, like, not necessarily fresher, just less likely to be brown.
Yeah. Also, like, iceberg lettuce is just, like, shape water.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is. It's just, like, I don't like eating massive not food, you know? I want my food to be food.
Yeah, you want it to have
eat things that aren't food.
Yeah. Like, I definitely get that. I mean, I'm a fan of, like, cucumber, and that's mostly water as well. But, like, at least it's got decent flavor. Like people make cucumber-flavored things. No one makes fucking iceberg lettuce-flavored soft drinks. There's no sparkling water that's, like, romaine.
I was about to, like, devil's advocate and be like, to be fair, they don't do that with spinach, but it's also, like, actually, they kind of put that in, like, a lot of, like, health shakes.
Yeah, like, a lot of health shakes have spinach in it. And not necessarily for flavor. It's because spinach has substance.
Yeah, I mean, I was on a shake kick for a long while, and I was a spinach boy. That's the way to do it, man. I forget what it was. I think it was, like, honeydew melon, and I had, like, a green shake, but it was, like, a fruity green shake.
I need to investigate shakes as a means to get more, like, vegetables in.
It might be good. I know you got your dietary stuff, and, like, there's a lot of versatility for what you can replace. You can get, like, lactose-free, like, extra protein milk, and, like...
Yeah.
I have no problem, like, drinking milk of any kind, but I would always use almond milk for shakes just because it's, like, it's sweet inherently, which just makes it a better, like... I don't know, like, dairy treat food.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm here for that. It's very difficult because I didn't grow up drinking milk, so I don't actually like a whole lot of the taste of it. And everything is trying to be milk, right? And it's just like...
Yeah.
So like, you get it trying to mimic the taste of milk and, like, the aftertaste of milk. And stuff like that. And then it just kind of ends up being not that. So it's like a shitty imitation of what is a normal thing. And it doesn't taste good in and of itself.
I just, like, didn't drink milk for a really long time. And then, like, was always using the almond milk. And then one day I just had, like, a glass of milk. And I was like, oh, this tastes weird now.
Yeah.
Like, it's not that bad. It's fine. But it's like. Also, have you watched much Always Sunny in Philadelphia?
No, I still have not. I should add it to the list that Salad Joel is making for me.
We could even sneak you an episode. But there's this family, and they're, like, inbred creeps who are also all criminals, and, like, they have a pure bloodline for generations. They're the McPoyles.
You lose something,
the Habsburgs.
And they're always... they're always drinking milk. Look, and then, like, there's a garb. All the women in the family wear, like, a really long t-shirt with nothing underneath. And then the men wear, like, a fucking... whatchamacallit? Just, like, an open robe with, like, tighty whities and an A-shirt. And it's, like... Most of my childhood, I was a full-blown McPoyle. That was my default state at home. I was milk-pilled. I was robe-pilled.
Ow. Ah, these guys are way better at fighting than the one dude.
You're a more tough guy. You should learn to take a hit.
Oh, I wasn't supposed to actually win that.
Get him downstairs and into the trunk.
Can you win that fight?
I am not entirely sure.
Like, I'm kind of curious. I have a feeling that someone just comes up behind you and, like, pistol whips you or something.
Oh, yeah, it forces it.
I kind of figured it would force it. You need to get to here.
Sure, he turned up all right. He's wishing he didn't. He's in the trunk. He's going nowhere. The boys introduced themselves.
Man, the boys... that is A-grade goon.
What do you want done with him, Mr. Monroe?
But the boys don't look particularly happy about this.
I know a good place. We'll pick up a shovel and a pick on the way. It's up in the hills behind Griffith Park.
The optimist in me wants me to believe that I can convince them to turn their life around. But the pessimist in me knows that I'll get a punch in the face for doing so. Oh, and they did not lock that car very well.
Elsa.
Can't draw my gun. Damn. I'm assuming I don't have it. I need to get into a vehicle. Is there any vehicle nearby? Damn.
Oh, this one you've already unlocked.
Oh, yeah? Where? Oh,
just
yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah, right over there. Okay. Uh-oh. Thanks for covering me? Firecrackers. I mean, that's fair. I would probably think the same. But I've lived downtown. But, you know. This is nice. This is nice and relaxing. I don't know where I am now.
Mm-hmm. You have palms. You have... Those are like some nice little lanterns.
Yeah.
No!
Well, that's awkward.
How dare you bother?
Damn it! You know what? Well, they're not on us. We need to switch vehicles.
Mm. High stealth, high stealth.
Shell game, let's go. We're hauling dirt now.
Hell yeah. Looks like some bee gravel quality shit.
Oh yeah.
What's your problem?
They'll still be able to follow my wake of destruction. I think I have shifted to the slowest possible vehicle. But you know what? It's kind of a tank. Alright.
They haven't been on you in like a minute straight. It's
yeah,
just
I know,
like
right?
Continuing this threatening music. Like.
Like, oh my god. They could be anywhere. They could be right on us. No, I think they're good. I think they're good.
Unfortunately, this was before the invention of the drift button in the car.
I mean, we still kind of got drift. You can brake.
Oh, yeah.
So, switch to this one.
Ooh. Oh, this one's got donuts.
Yeah. Even though it's open top, so they'd be able to clearly see me in the car.
That's alright. They'd be like, he would never be so daring.
Yeah.
And then just think it's not. Ooh, that end comes out good.
Yeah. Yeah, this car is driftable. I like it. All right, we're here. Let's go.
Kelso is just like snapping to himself, syncopated like deja vu. I have been in this place before.
Just converted into like a jazz swing beat. I'm so here for that.
Oh yeah, that could work well. Like, and then you could do like a little like do 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 do. You could even do like the threatening fucking trombone where they're like wah.
Wah, wah.
I'll say the boo boo.
So you're still carrying that Army 45, Cole?
To be fair, Cole was on it.
For God's sake, Cole! Call an ambulance!
That was such a comedic fall.
It's also so good at conveying he had no idea he was about to fall over. He was just like about to go on a diatribe.
Yeah. I am going to fucking crush this dude and then just fall. Just fall. So good.
Sinister flute. More sinister flute.
Satchel charges on the cave entrance from above. Covering fire on weapons team. Look for snipers in the trees. You know the drill. No risks, no heroes, no prisoners.
You want some roast on this one, Sarge?
No, you guys have done enough. Head back to Webb's. We are going to blow every cave we come across. Close them down and move on, people.
Damn. I was hoping to get me a samurai sword.
Skipper says that Phelps has fallen behind again. He's got his fire teams checking every cave. He's lost another flamethrower. He wants you to get over there and hurry them along.
Hogaboom. Weapons company.
Sir.
Sir.
We have a major cave complex in front of us, Hogaboom. I want flamethrowers and BAR teams to clean it out.
Pardon, sir. Hogaboom. It's a big complex. Why don't we bring the Shermans in? They could pour it in there.
We can't wait for tanks to be brought up. I'm already behind.
Then blow the cave. No skin off our nose. Bury them
in
it.
We are going in there and clearing them out. We are doing it by the numbers, Sergeant. Get your team in place.
One of the wildest things about tank weaponry is that people have realized you can just breach the barrel in
first fire team
and then pump something through the tube.
Head in.
Yeah.
So it's like that's what they did in Waco in Japan. They would use it with like flamethrowers. Like maybe even in World War II they did that sometimes.
Yeah, I believe
it. Like it's a nasty thing.
Where's he going? Where's who going?
Although I do like the fucking the trapezoid wheels.
He's
on
going
World
in.
War I
who
tanks.
Gave that order? You did.
Track, I should say.
Oh, it's just a polite invitation. Lovely. Congratulations. You're now addicted to drugs.
He's just like, can I be in the polycule? Sorry, it's the drugs. Hi, Elsa.
Sitting there.
Not long, Mr. Kelso.
You look lovely, princess. You have really caught me at my best.
That would have been perfectly not, like, just a line you expect from him, but something about it being after polycule was just like...
Yeah, after the polycule invitation is just kind of like, all right...
Hey, Discord Dotem energy.
What can I do for you?
I'd like to explain because I
can join Elsa could run a polycule.
Cole needs your help.
Like, 100%.
The police department have frozen him out.
Oh yeah, she's the one who makes the goo.
Obviously a brave lady, but you can't fight all Cole's battles for him.
As someone who lives that way, but in a very casual, just like, do it as it goes kind of way. I find like the elaborate polycules hilarious because they all seem like it's just.
Tell me something.
A cancerous, giant, abusive relationship.
He was a cop.
Like so many of them, you hear these wild stories. Like, there's a Strange Aeons video on, like, a Portland polycule where they had, like, cleaning schedules and, like...
Yeah, that's the type of stuff that I always find absolutely wild whenever I hear about it. It's just kind of like...
More dots to join, and it's making my head hurt.
The idea of having schedules... and things like that for relationships is bonkers to me. Absolutely bonkers.
that's kind of what I'm trying to avoid, is the weird control.
You're right? If we could just, you know, have it just be relaxed and do as we need to do.
You Kelso?
That's pretty much it.
Who's asking?
Peterson, assistant DA.
You're in the wrong building, Peterson. This is a hospital.
A wise guy. Let me tell you a story, Kelso.
Can I get the abridged version? My head hurts.
You're a funny guy, Jack.
What do you want, Peterson?
A colorful character mentioned your name. He said that you might know something about...
There's a problem with colorful characters, Peterson. First they send you over a drink, then they buy you dinner, then you get a phone call in the middle of the night for a favor. Try rubbing shoulders with some solid citizens. They're the ones you're supposed to protect.
You finished, Kelso?
For the moment.
I'm going to run for DA, Kelso. The current administration...
I can't tell if he's wearing eyeliner or not.
I'm looking for a DA's investigator. You get a gun
Either way,
and a
solid.
Badge and $120 a month.
I get $150 a month now.
I'm going after the vice squad, Kelso. It's going to get me elected.
I've got something better. How about Leland Monroe?
The property developer?
Do you think I fell down the stairs?
Well, those are well-polished floors.
Yeah, solid. Like, this is some polished wood.
It's looking like a moderate slip hazard, like...
Yeah.
Thanks for the patch-up, Princess. Might be the only R&R I get for some time.
I hate that he calls every woman princess.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. I heard the doo-doo-doo.
I think it was the magazine.
Magazine. Oh.
I don't know, a cup.
Seems unrelated.
Wawa, a sandwich Phelps. Oh, shit. I gotta get to a sub shop stat.
Fuck, I need a sandwich. Need a sandwich to talk to. So goddamn bad. What is this? Is there anything?
Say, Elsa, you ever feel like you devour the ones you love? And he looks longingly to an empty wrapper in the car.
I have a feeling that Elsa would not be a sandwich. Elsa would be a flower in like a flower pot or something. I have a feeling like every person is a different inanimate object.
I like the idea that Elsa is just literal Elsa and she's the only person that knows about the depth of his delusion.
See, that is also fantastic.
The only person in Los Angeles who knows that he talks to sandwiches.
There's a magazine here. Nope. Crime! Oh, there's my car. Excellent.
You got into a good parking spot.
Yeah. Solid. Like that they're reminding me that I can just hold E to go to the destination. Like, come on. Come on. We all know what I'm gonna do. I
Why
like driving in this game.
Why would you say that to Drift King 2000?
I mean, I'd love to be Drift King 2000.
Maybe you could say that to Drift King 2001. He's a bit conceited. He's a sellout. But Drift King 2000?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. That is me. I stay there. Till the end.
Someone has to carry on the legacy of Drift King 1999. Rest in peace. Rest in power. I'm hoping the kiss of two fingers to the sky was audible there.
Yes, it was portrayed. I heard it. I felt it.
It's been a long day. got you, my friend. Good day.
Not gonna lie, I've been trying to come up with a, like, rest in peace, but for, like, racing. I guess it's just race in peace or something like that. But, like, I kept trying to, like, I was like, drift in peace, my king. Drift in peace, my king. Mm-hmm. Drift King 1999. May you drift in peace.
Somewhere he's drifting in the sky. Yeah. Princess. Jack Kelso too far into the interview trying to be like, how would you feel about daddy? How would...
would you go for drift daddy? Yes? No? Okay.
You know what? No, that's not what I'm about. I guess what I really want to ask... I'm interested in it, too. It's just... Would you call me insurance investigator?
I just really like insurance investigator.
Hey, remember what the jump scares are in this game?
Remember me?
There are jump scares?
It's good to see you.
Oh, yeah, we've had
you
some.
Caught me at a slightly inopportune
it's more
moment.
Of a jump horror.
Can we
but,
do this some other time?
Back off, Curtis.
Oh, right.
Jack, there's no call for that. You're smooth, Curtis. I'll give you that.
Okay, I'm ready.
You try to get me killed and you still manage to be polite about it.
Jack, how could you accuse me of having anything to do with that?
I want to know all about you and Monroe, Curtis. You give it up or I beat it out of you.
Get the fuck out of here, Jack. You're fired. Who do you think you are? Get out of town now while you still have the chance. You have no idea what kind of forces you're dealing with here.
I guess we've exhausted the passive options.
Oh, fuck.
Sit tight, Curtis. I'm taking a look around.
I kind of like that Kelso will pistol whip you. Yeah. Phelps would not.
Phelps would definitely not.
All right. So that was...
Okay.
Princess.
16, mister?
Oh, God. Okay.
How old are you really?
Nearly 13.
Okay, the egg was not necessary, but I feel like I need an egg for my ears.
Love, Curtis.
Some might find your romantic notions endearing, Jack. I find them very tiring.
You're finished, Curtis.
That remains to be seen, Jack.
I haven't told you about my new job, Curtis. DA's investigator.
Who do you think the DA reports to, Jack?
Get dressed. You're getting out of here.
He's not so bad. He just lays on top of me and grunts for a few minutes. He's kind. And he buys me nice things.
Get dressed, you're leaving.
You're the adult in the room and you don't want to be like, this is going to result in a debilitating lifelong trauma. So you're like, listen, you gotta, she's like, but he buys me Skittles. And like, the special Skittles?
I just really like the description of it as just, he just lays over top of me and grunts.
Yeah!
That feels like a, is it in yet, kind of dig, where it's just like, oh god. That's gotta bruise a man's ego right there. California grown.
It's like, listen, I can explain. She's like, listen, it's only 15 seconds of my time and I get the spicy Skittles. Remember the spicy Skittles?
Fucking spicy Skittles.
Get out while you can.
And that's what we're going to focus on. We're going to think of the spicy...
Lesion, Curtis. Now I know why.
Oh.
We're going to think of the spicy Skittles. That's what we're going to focus on.
Hmm. That's a pretty good life insurance policy. Elysian Fields development. Okay.
What exactly do you expect to find, Jack?
A magazine.
You're like, aha, you pick up Committing Crimes magazine.
Hey, I believe it at this point. I've picked up many a crime magazine.
You think I don't know the names of your popular crime-o-mags, Jack?
Fucking crime-o-mags.
You know, Goon Weekly, Mook Monthly, Thug Quarterly.
Jack, you've made a terrible mistake.
Well, this one has lipstick on it.
Get out while you can.
So clearly, you must wear lipstick. That is the only inference you can make about this. Alright. Let's see what he has to say, shall we?
I want answers, Curtis. So pay attention.
Please, Jack. I'm not a violent man.
I don't get it, Curtis. You're vice president of the company. Why take the risk?
It's a simple business transaction, dear boy.
He waggles his sandwich. Why the fuck you lying? Come on, let's be professional, Cole.
Just starts, like, swerving it around. Getting it in a dancing mood. Let's see. I'm just probably going to doubt him, but I also need to turn on a light.
Oh, wait, what are your... What's your evidence again?
Inferior lumber.
Leave the conversation and keep looking.
I don't know if I can.
Can you, like, back out now?
No.
Like, B?
Oh, okay, there we go. All right, I'll turn around.
What exactly do you expect to find, Jack?
Dining room table. That's where all of it is.
Oh. Yeah, I completely missed this.
To get all of the stockholders, I need to follow the paper trail.
Gonna do some taps.
Jack, you've made a terrible mistake. Get out while you can.
I can't tap on this one. Okay.
Is there anything else on that table? Oh no, you have the insurance agreement. We're good then.
Okay.
Some desk to the left of it.
Yep. I found that one just fine.
I don't get it, Curtis. You're vice president of the company. Why take the risk?
It's a simple business transaction, dear boy.
You're lying, Curtis. Something happened at the company, didn't it? That's why you took the bribe.
Bribe? What bribe? How can you accuse me of benefiting ahead of the company?
This?
Maybe.
Yeah, let's go with this.
I noticed that the share certificates are in your name, Curtis, not the company's. What did you use as collateral?
Those sons of bitches in Sacramento. They passed me over for president. Sent me here because they believed it was a backwater. But they were wrong. Los Angeles will become the capital of the West, not San Francisco. This place will be the city of the 20th century. And I'm gonna get my cut, Jack.
You're going to jail, Curtis. You and your cronies.
We'll see about that, Jack. Ooh,
that was the one that would have been good for the magazines. Cronies. I gotta use
cronies. Yes. Crimes and Cronies magazine.
Tell me about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
You're talking about the future of Los Angeles. You cannot interfere with these plans.
Information, Curtis.
Business people who have joined forces to meet the demand for new homes.
You're lying, Curtis. They're going to burn those movie sets they call houses, and you're carrying the insurance on them.
And how do you prove that, Jack?
From the insurance agreement on your table over there.
Rancho Escondido burnt to the ground. California Fire and Life is carrying the paper.
Jack, the best result you could get from insurance would be replacement cost. The stakes are much, much higher.
Why the big payoff in the Buckwalter case? It was bound to bring it to attention.
Who could have predicted this particular confluence of events? Elsa Lichtman as the beneficiary who spurns the cash. The brilliant but flawed detective becoming her lover. And you, Jack, taking their bait.
You buy green lumber and use it to build houses. How do you expect it to end?
Mr. Monroe has a fine reputation for building houses. What would I know about his choice of building materials?
I'm still gonna see what the lie option is.
You smug son of a bitch. You're lying again. It's an insurance scam, pure and simple.
And how do you prove that, Jack? My assessors wrote the policies on the houses.
Is the inferior lumber? Like, if they have it, if they're valuing the house much higher, and they say that they got building material for a certain price, but then they're using inferior lumber purchased at a cheaper price, then the insurance payout would pay out more money. But
you just have wood.
Hmm?
You have wood from Keystone Films that was on the properties.
Yeah.
But this guy's name is nothing near it.
True.
I just have to push him.
Sorry. Yeah.
My mistake.
Give me what I need or I'll beat it out of you.
It's all there in the case file. If you know what to look for.
Very neat, Curtis. Maybe I can't work it out, but Phelps can. He may be many things, but he is one of the best detectives the LAPD has ever had.
Your card is marked, Jack. You'll have an unfortunate accident if you don't leave town.
Your California isn't the same as mine, Mr. Benson. Not at all.
Yeah, good timing.
Yeah.
He waits until he can't see him, and then he's like, yeah, you're the best detective in the LAPD, and he furiously eats his fucking chicken bacon teriyaki.
He's got a fucking shawarma wrap. Yeah, you're the best sandwich in the LAPD.
Takes a big bite. He's like, you know, I always underestimate the noble beat.
Fuck. I was going so smooth for a while there. So smooth.
You almost barnstormed it.
Almost barnstormed it.
Must be.
Ah, fuck.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm like, it looks fine. Keep driving.
You quietly take your insurance papers out from the glove compartment, ignite them, like, throw them on the engine block.
Ooh. Car. Might take a while. I need to use your car to get to another car.
Out! Right now!
Be careful with it, copper!
Alright, let's see what we got at this new location. Shall we?
Oh, we shall.
Not gonna lie, I was waiting for myself to slow down as I was holding E to exit the vehicle. Like, that's such a modern thing of, like, when a person is holding E, the character just breaks until they get out. Yes.
This thing's just an eraser.
The very first thing I thought of when looking at this thing was, it's a bean!
Oh, it's a little guy.
It's such a little guy. Oh. It's zippy, though. Holy crap. Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Oh, yeah, this thing's a fucking racer.
Yeah.
What's your problem?
God. God, Sandwich Phelps. Why can't you just drive?
I have impulse control issues, Jack. You said it, Sandwich Phelps. Oomph.
Turkey today. If Phelps was a sandwich, what do you think he would be?
A bagel belt.
Oh, fuck.
He has the veneer of innovation, but he's ultimately milk toast.
Yeah.
And all he's doing is adding more egg to the table.
Yeah.
And, like, egg is, it changes the sandwich category.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, a normal, like, bagel BLT is, it's good. But adding that egg makes it a hearty sandwich.
Control your car.
Well, especially with the bacon, it's like you have the thin, tasty thing you want, and then it's like you have this squidginess. Because whenever they do it at like a restaurant, it's never like a nice egg, unless it's at like a good restaurant that's about to fail financially.
Yeah.
Like, it's always that weird accurate. Muffin tin bullshit.
Very fucking accurate.
Like, I've had some really good breakfast sandwiches in my life, and they all either come from failed businesses or ones that are only open, like, Wednesday to Saturday, like, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
I'm just going up to my office, Barty. Gotta check over some files.
Take the elevator. First door on the right when you come out. You know the way, Kelso.
Yeah, you don't need to fucking
thanks.
Tell me.
Right. Oh, I need the help. Thanks.
But yeah, I was gonna say, yes, I've also had like a couple of really good sandwiches. The one benefit of working at a Tim Hortons is you just get to make up a sandwich for your lunch shift.
Oh yeah.
And especially because it was like, my shift was always, you know, just before lunch rush or something like that. So I was like getting the end of breakfast. And so I could just be like, yeah, load up like 3 eggs on there. Is you're about to throw it away? Fuck it.
To accompany me to church.
My unfortunate experience from like food service jobs is that whenever I get like fries, it's always like, you were supposed to put it in a new batch about 10 minutes ago, and they should have been in this tray 5 minutes ago.
Yep. It's the worst thing. Trying to predict food is terrible. Especially because, in my experience, you have... You try and predict. You do a really good job of predicting which foods are going to go down. And then all of a sudden, like, some American family comes in and order 2, like, 12 packs of one very specific donut for their breakfast. Grown men playing at being boys. And it's just like, well, there was never going to be a chance of this working out. Now, was there?
If you were twice as smart, you'd still be.
So, Curtis.
I'm trying to remember, I think it was a Simpsons gag. What was in the Good Morning Burger?
Okay,
34 degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west.
Okay, 19
insured
seconds.
Replacement value for the house is $900.
Let's see what we got.
Current value of the house and land is $3,500. Christ, how many of these dumps are we carrying on the books?
I have a Detective Phelps of the LAPD here to see you.
Have a seat, Cole.
Okay, so I've just been haunted by reality.
She's awfully easy on the eye for a foreign girl.
Does that private dick petter actually work on anyone, Kelso? It's not your style. You were always a little more direct.
Dick patter. I'm sorry, I got derailed.
Yeah, I was really distracted. I was not listening to what you said. The dick patter was so good.
Fuck you, Cole. Be a man. Why send a woman to do your dirty work? You're a cop. Why do you want my help?
I thought a PI might be a little more discreet.
I'm no gumshoe. I used to be an investigator for this company before your investigation got me fired.
I'm sorry to hear that, Jack. I'm sorry about a lot of things.
Is that an apology, Cole?
It's a feeble attempted one, yes. Look, Jack, it's a murder case, and I need help to solve it.
So what's it got to do with Elysian Fields developments?
They're in it somehow. The flyers keep turning up whenever I find a domestic fire.
They're boosters. Stiffing GIs for deposits, making them wait months for a throw-up house. They're already making more money than they can count. What's turned them into killers?
So you believe me?
This is why you dragged me into the Buckwalter case.
Look, Jack, I'm sorry. But if not for me, do it for some of the poor saps who are dying. Or some of the leathernecks who are getting grifted. How about it, Jack?
I know you, Cole. You're still beating yourself up over that medal on Sugarloaf. The medal you think you didn't deserve, but you just don't get it. Nobody deserves a medal. It's just the ridiculous situation you find yourself in and how you react to it. You think you failed up on that hill. But courage isn't a tap you can turn on or off. Courage isn't permanent. It's a tenuous and fickle thing. Courage and cowardice exist in every man. Get over it.
You got it off your chest.
I guess I have.
Can you help me?
It's so much nicer to say that to a real Cole than a sandwich Cole.
The Hall of
Cole leaves the office. Start. He speed dials his therapist. All right, so the Good Morning Burger is a ground beef patty. You drizzle it with rich creamery butter.
Okay.
Like on top of the burger after it's on the bottom bun.
Okay.
It's bacon, ham, and a fried egg.
Okay.
And like that was an elaborate, like, ridiculous Simpson joke, but in my head it's like, okay, the butter's a bit much.
Yeah.
But like,
but as for the rest of it. Oh,
like,
God.
If you change the ground beef for ground sausage, that's just like your standard breakfast.
Yeah. Is this dude going to be like, oh, no, not you.
Hello there.
Or that was a different place.
No, that was cool.
There, sir?
Oh,
same
true.
Place, but it was cool.
The land registry office. Where is it?
Just up the stairs.
He comes up. He's like, I am normal and can be trusted with chandeliers.
It's fine. They haven't replaced the last one. Oh, land registry office. Land registry office. How nice of them.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to see the company details of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Everyone complains about bureaucracy, but without bureaucracy, how would you get tiny signs?
Honestly, I think that bureaucracy really has been the leading cause in small sign development breakthroughs in the past 20 years.
Mm-hmm. As well as painted floor line.
Mm-hmm.
All those suburban sons of bitches ought to be listed in here.
Alright, so we got Southern Film Casting. We got Standing and Sons. We got Santa Forth Betting Agency. Stillwater Veteran Homes Care sounds pretty solid, but... Deglin and Davis. Not seeing anything there. I assume I have to look at the names.
Maybe it's the next page, because we're looking for suburban development.
Oh, I can. Okay. I can turn the page. Oh, yep. Gonna keep.
Courtney Sheldon?
Where? Oh.
Courtney. For God's sake. What's he got to do with this? I'd like information on a plot of land.
Okay, do you have the address?
Not exactly. It's a new lot. I have the coordinates. 34 degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west.
All right, that makes it a bit more difficult.
Are you ready for flashbacks?
I'm so ready for flashbacks. And also, what were you doing anyway? You were just working the front desk. I mean, come on.
Mm-hmm.
34 degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west.
I see.
1758.
I was going the wrong way. That makes a lot more sense.
The lot number's 1876988.
Unfortunately, that is just the beginning. We have at least a million lot numbers in the Los Angeles area. Registrations are in alphabetical order. You need to convert your lot number to a letter.
How do I do that?
Over here.
Bureaucracy!
There are 90,000 entries to a book, so divide your lot number by 90,000.
Uh-huh.
1876988. Divided by...
90,000, yes.
Okay, 1, 8.
1, 8, 8.
Oh no, it's 1, 8, 7.
Oh, fuck. No. I'm just gonna...
1,876,988.
1, 8, 7, 6. Alright. Seven, six, and then we have to make that million.
988.
Oh, 988. Okay.
1, 8, 7, 6, 9.
Thank you, subtitles.
Yeah.
Divided by 90,000. Yes.
I love the little, oh yes, 90,000, have you mentioned? Yes.
It's only been mentioned a couple of times. There we go.
Crank it. Crank that hog.
Oh yeah.
20. A starts at 0, that, so you want to add 1.
That doesn't sound like it would be a solid number on that, but alright.
Once you have the letter, find
we're
the
cutting
mail,
off the remainder here.
You are in business.
Mm-hmm.
You do this every day?
Well, do you? Oh, sorry. 20th letter of the alphabet, right?
Mm-hmm.
What would that be?
Well, 21st.
Let's see what the site is worth to them.
Okay, 988.
1, 8, 7, 6, 9.
Randall Jones.
The book value is 350. With the new home in place, the improved value of the property is 3,500. They can make a killing. But how do they pull it off?
No, I feel so sorry for the desk, dude.
The extra trunk space.
One thing you learn in the war, boys. You do your talking once the smoke clears.
Hook your head up, bud. There we go.
Thank.
Throw out the...
Yeah, fuck. Fuck! I knew there was someone sneaking around, but I still had to go for it.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're a doggone cowboy.
Yeah.
Know why I plumb for the caddy? The extra trunk space.
One thing you learn in the war, boys. You do your talking once the smoke clears.
Still gonna...
Christ. Just missed.
I thought so.
I got you!
Ow. Fuck.
Weapons on the ground, now!
Engaging in active hat preservation.
Yep. It's necessary.
Looks like someone's almost behind
me. I know, right? There's no active door there. So I think he's just being a doofus in the hallway. Got me. Ah, fuck.
Ooh, get his gun.
Oh, that's a shotgun. Damn, that's got the DACA.
Indeed it does.
I need a word, Courtney.
That's okay, Jack. You didn't need to come all the way down.
It's
here.
Important, Courtney.
How can I help?
Why aren't you asking what happened to my face, Courtney?
What are you talking about?
Don't fuck with me, Courtney!
Jack, I swear, I don't know what you're talking about.
How does your name appear as one of the investors in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
You're out of your mind.
I was down at the Hall of Records checking on a property company called Elysian Fields Developments. Their funding comes from the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Seriously, Jack, I have no idea.
Your name is there, Courtney, with some pretty interesting company. The mayor, the district attorney, some dirty cops, and your buddy, Dr. Harlan Fontaine.
Dr. Fontaine?
Spill it, Courtney. I want all of it. Fontaine and the rest.
Fontaine took the morphine off our hands. Look, Jack, I know you said to get rid of it, but it's okay.
Jack was in on it.
I did something good for once. He reinvested the money for us. That's it. That's what's happening. They're building houses for GIs, Jack. I turned a mistake into something beneficial, something that's going to help out the guys.
Courtney, they're building matchstick houses. They're going to burn them for the insurance money. They'll probably stiff the poor bastards for the deposits.
Please, Jack. Say it isn't so.
Just look at the number of houses that have already burned down.
He helps out a lot of people.
Looks like he's helping himself, Courtney. You're the fall guy.
Someone's calling me. I have the loudest phone in the world.
Jack Kelso.
Who's asking?
Leland Monroe.
I was wondering when you'd get around to calling.
I'd like to meet with you, Mr. Kelso.
I bet you would, Mr. Monroe. But I value my skin highly enough to not want to meet with you. Why don't you just send some more of your boys around and we'll have a nice cup of tea?
You realize that I could make you a very wealthy man, Mr. Kelso.
Better than $220 a month?
You're a very witty man,
I'm going to have to let it slide, Mr. Monroe.
Are you haggling with me, Jack?
I might be.
Come around to my place at 9. 5164 Santa Monica Boulevard. You'll come?
I might. Good night, Mr. Monroe.
I miss the days when, like, the phone receiver was, like, this thing that a person had to deal with while on a phone call.
You have to pick up a box that's connected by two different, like, jiggly coil wires.
Yeah, and you just have to manage both of them.
The jiggle in the wire means that you can't actually tell when you're under tension.
Yeah.
So you have no idea if you're yanking just to get, like, a quarter of the way around the corner, or if you're about to rip it off of a hook.
It was a fun little guessing game.
I'm sure people will be the same, saying the same thing about, like, flipping USBs over.
Oh, yeah.
But walking away from your laptop with your headphones on.
Oh, God. Damn it. Yeah. I do that all the time. Well, actually, it's not necessarily that I, like, walk away with my headphones still on or something like that. It's that because of the way the cord works, it hooks onto my desk a lot of the time. And so what would be a perfectly reasonable distance is now halved. And so normally I'm able to, like, walk around my entire room with my headphones on. But if it hooks around, I can barely even stand up.
It really does grip the road.
What?
It's got that zip.
Yeah, it's nice. I like it. It just kind of figures out where it wants to go and just keeps on going.
Watch it!
And then I ruin it. Uh-oh. I got a rare achievement.
California drivers.
I have more than 194.7 miles.
Ooh.
I don't know why that specific amount, but I have the achievement.
Maybe it's like total quest length, like the amount you have to drive. So it's like deliberately driving more. I don't know.
I'm gonna go. I could see it being something along the lines of, like, the circumference of the map.
Oh, yeah.
This is gonna go well. This is definitely going to go well.
I appreciate the help, all of you. We can reminisce later. I want a minimum of noise and no prisoners.
No prisoners? This isn't Pele Lu, Jack.
These guys are grifting GIs. That's what they do for a living.
It's okay, Jack. We all feel the same way. Just hasn't turned out quite the way we imagined.
Let's get it done. Teams of two at the ready.
Now, do I try to go in silent?
Might as well at least get better situated.
Oh. Yeah. How do I get in cover? Oh, there we go. Okay, nope, that didn't work.
Gotta get the deck.
These guys are doing a great job.
Yeah.
Where are they? I'm gonna do what they do.
How long do you think you can hold out?
Just close range. Just firing at whatever I can.
You're surrounded and your buddies are dead.
Oh god, there's even more. Oh god. Don't kill me, don't kill me, don't kill me, don't kill me, don't kill me. Okay.
Nice. Alright, we just gotta wait for the television to get color again, I guess.
Yeah. Damn it! I didn't realize they had limited ammo.
Move up.
I was having fun with that. What happened to your guns? Damn it.
Alright, man, hold the perimeter. I got personal business with Mr. Leland Monroe.
That was fucking loud. All right. Hi, Salajal.
Welcome to Val.
Weapons on the ground.
Ah, fuck. Weapons on the ground. I'm already being shot.
Get the shack.
Fuck that guy. I'm too sophisticated for them. I wear my top hat now. Rawr.
I'm just Fallout brained, but the way that pool cue was positioned under the light, it gives the impression you could like grab it and just bash people around with it.
That'd be great.
You're just like, ah, oh, there's my cue.
There he is! Blast him! Keep on going, Jack.
Jack, how many bullets would you say are in your body at this given moment?
You're a very sweet-looking girl to be holding such a big gun.
I know how to use it, mister.
I'm sure you do.
No.
So how about pointing it over there in the direction of Hollywood instead of at me, princess?
You're quite the wise guy.
I don't normally shoot women, princess. How about putting the cannon down? I didn't think you had the guts, sweetheart. I was never very good at reading women.
Sandwiches, though.
Monroe! Where are you, damn it?
He starts putting lipstick on his hoodies.
Like, did Kelso at all ever think that this might not be his house?
God damn!
Every day he is innovating in the niche industry of being shot.
Yeah. Oh! That felt like a twofer. Just watch the other guy drop behind him. Not gonna lie, I was expecting you to turn the corner here and a guy sitting on the toilet just pulls a gun and shoots.
Jack Kelso.
That's my opening negotiating position. Oh, you crazy son of a bitch. How did you get in here? I'm bleeding to death. Get me a doctor. I thought I had an invitation, Monroe. Your boys outside were certainly expecting me. That's my second offer. You sadistic bastard. What do you want? I'm going to take a look around, Monroe. Then I want you to tell me what you know about the mayor and those Trojan houses that you're building.
Newspaper. But first,
the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. Remind me what they say about absolute power, Monroe. Fuck you, Jack.
That's not what they say about absolute power.
Already.
I have met plenty of people with absolute power, and none of them have fucked me.
Dr. Fontaine, I need to speak with you urgently.
Sit down, please, sit down.
Tell me about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
It's the fund we are using to channel money into the development of new houses.
Why is my name on the board of managers?
Technically, you are a major contributor. Please, Courtney.
Those houses are a sham, Doctor. They're going to be burned for the insurance.
That's a scandalous allegation, Courtney. Do you have any proof?
Jack Kelso, an investigator for California Fire and Life, has seen them. He was almost killed when he found out what was going on.
I don't know what to say. I feel that I have been duped. Who do you think is behind?
I've been bamboozled, thoroughly hoodwinked.
Mm-hmm.
Jack says it's a property developer named Monroe. He said it goes all the way to the mayor.
You cannot have believed that I was involved.
I don't know what to believe anymore, Doctor. I hoped that you weren't involved.
Thank you for your trust, dear boy.
Be still, Courtney.
God, that kind of
troubles are finally over.
That kind of movement would not be great. It really wiggled the needle in that dude's neck.
Oh yeah, he eagle waggled him.
Let them drift away.
Well, surprisingly, it wasn't Phelps that got someone murdered.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you get any of these guns out of the locker?
Well, everything you're looking for, I believe, is in one place.
Let me guess. The safe.
That's a hell of a payroll.
There's something on the desk. There's a file.
Oh, see, I tried to get one on the desk, but yeah, maybe I just wasn't in the right spot.
I'm guessing Benson's portfolio is only a fraction the size of yours, Monroe.
So he's blackmailing?
Smart. Keep the dirt on Fontaine under lock and key.
Nice.
Whose signature
is
that?
Insurance.
Motherfucker.
I was holding my tongue so hard every time you were like, boy, I hope he's not our next partner.
Well, I mean, I knew what was I didn't know what was happening, but like, come on.
The sinking feeling.
Come on. Really?
Some sold up. The others obviously didn't know the lengths these sons of bitches would go to.
Sawyer and Steffens.
It can't be stopped, Kelso. There's too much money at stake.
Kingdoms rise and kingdoms fall, Monroe. Ask the Emperor of Japan.
Have some fucking mercy!
Operator, put me through to Phelps, arson squad.
Yeah, Biggs, it's Jack. I'm at Monroe's. He's in a talkative mood. If you get here in a hurry, you might get something before he bleeds to death. Elsa. Oh,
thank God.
Where? Fontaine. Dead? Former patient.
Can you use more so full sentences, please?
Son of a bitch finally came left back for a checkup.
Antler.
It's Monroe. He's raving.
Sandwich?
You want information, cocksucker. You get me some medical help.
I've got to go, Herschel. Monroe's negotiating again. Do you want my final offer, Leland? Tell me how I find the guy who has Elsa.
Not Casey. He did whatever Fontaine asked. He had some kind of power over him. He did all the fires and then he went off the rails. I don't have a fucking name! He worked as a bug sprayer. Get me a goddamn doctor! Kelso, you son of a whore! Get me a goddamn doctor!
Just kind of crawl around a little bit. You'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
Nailed that investigation.
Yeah. Well, we should probably cut it here, but we should watch the intro to this.
Of course.
It's a real banger.
What? Okay. Statewide you said that, now I feel like there's an explosion.
Yeah, something up his sleeve. He's not worried about being caught.
So how do we help?
We go after the other side of the equation. Jack has a lesion and its cronies running scared. We go after the doctor and some of the other guys.
But the whole department breathing down our necks.
It's time for action, Herschel. It's time for change. Jack's crossed the Rubicon and we have to be on the other side ready to help him.
Christ, there it is.
Jesus Christ, that's a big explosion.
Something big.
You think it's the Reds? You think those rusky sons of bitches that dropped the H-bomb on us?
Calm down.
You would all be dead.
I need to be ready for the call.
I'm not waiting for an invitation. Get in the car and head for the cloud. KGPL can give us the details on the way.
All units, reports of an explosion. Roger the location. It's south of Santa Monica.
South of Santa Monica, west of... Oh, shit.
Yeah. Are we going to the explosion, or do you want to sign off your work?
Did it autosave?
I did not see it autosave, but it was the beginning of a mission, so... It should be good.
Downtown, explosion, not good.
Downtown explosion, not looking forward to that. Like, yeah, I think we only have two cases left then. Yeah, this one and the next one.
And this one's DLC.
Oh, okay. Wait, or is this the last one?
This is the second last.
Okay. I was going to say.
I think it's main story and then it's not including this one.
Okay. Well, in that case, next time we'll have to figure out who dropped a bomb in the middle of downtown.
Mm-hmm.
So be sure to tune in for that. As always,
I'm sure they electroplated it.
Oh yes, I'm sure they electroplated it. It's in the title. It's in the title. But yeah, thank you everyone for watching, and we'll see y'all next time. Bye.